Okay, so in the last video, we were looking at the substring function. So let's continue in that vein and look at the if-else statement. So here in our business layer, any calc fields should always be defined in the business layer, not at the database layer or at the presentation layer. Always in the business layer, because that way, whenever you're looking for a calc, you always know which layer it's in. It's in the business layer. So you remember we have a table of payments, right? And it has these fields in it. Actually, and in the presentation layer we have the payments here, right, with these fields, right? But in the business layer it's called payments, right? So let's look at the definition of that. And it's got these fields in it. So for example, there's a field called salary that comes from the payments table. Here's a calculation, the salary monthly, which is the annual salary divided by 12. That's a calc field. So let's do another calc field, right? Suppose there is a withholding tax. Okay, so let's add a field here. So suppose we have a field called the withholding tax. Withholding tax. And that would be, say, you could say it's the salary times 0.10, right? 10%. Say that withholding tax is 10% of the salary, right? Okay, so there's the withholding tax there, right? We can validate this here. Okay, let's test it. Okay, so if the salary is $150,000, then the withholding tax is $15,000, and so on, right? That's all good, right? But normally taxes are not that simple, right? They're usually on some kind of graded scale, right? So let's go to the definition, see, click on the ellipsis. And we'll use the if-then-else construct. So if you click on functions here, click on constructs, click on if-then-else. Let's drag that over to the beginning. See the line there at the beginning? Okay, and it's if a condition, then something else expression, something else, right? And this thing is going to be the expression. So I'll cut that. And then I'll delete there where it says angle bracket expression, because you just delete that stuff out and you replace it with whatever the real expression is, right? Same thing with the other expression. Okay, so if you've ever worked with any programming language, you understand what if-then-else is. If you haven't, then I'll explain, right? Normally, for something like a tax, you could say if the salary is less than 100,000.00, then the tax would be 0.5%. Else, if the salary is 100,000 or more, then the tax is 10%, right? That's a normal kind of condition. Let's try running it. Yeah, it's running okay. Let's try testing it. Okay, let's look for an example. There's 100,000 and it's 10,000, right? That's right on the borderline. There's 150,000. It's 15,000, right? Let's look for one that's less than 100,000. If we don't have one that's less than 100,000, so I will quickly go to the database and stick one in there. Okay, here I am in my database. Here's my payments table. right? Let's just change some of these. 99,999.99 and 99,888.88 and $77, so on. Okay, close this. Now let me go back, run a test again. There's a 77, right? Sticking 5% of $77. There's a 99,888. Let's say that's 5% of that. Certainly is not 10%, that's for sure. So we can assume it's working here. Validate, right? And you could even do more, like a lot of times with something like income tax. There's more than two grades, right? So you could make a similar if-then-else construct. Okay, I could copy that. Then put that down here. Paste this in here. Right, so we could say if it's less than 1,000. Okay, if it's less than 1,000, it'll be 2%. Right? Else, otherwise, if it is dot dot dot, right? So what would happen if you try to run this? It works. Well, it looks like it works, right? So far so good. Let's try like a validate. Yeah, looks okay so far. Let's try a test. Okay, here's our 77. That's 2% because it's less than 1,000, right? Here's the 999. That's 5%, right? Here's 100,000. It's, well, that's a million. That's 100,000 is the tax, right? So that's how you do the if-then-else. Again, just like I said in the previous video, you can do this at the framework manager level, or you could do it at the Import Studio level, right? If you're doing it at framework manager, remember to publish the package after you finish it. Okay, so here I am in Report Studio. I'll just create a dummy report for testing purposes. Let's say it is the cities. There's the cities, right? And there's the fields in the cities, right? So you see that, say there's a country name field, which is Canada or United States or something else, right? So suppose we had a calc field in here, right? If then else field on this query, right? Go to toolbox, query calculation. Okay, so let's call this continent. Continent, right? And then what'll it be? Go to our function tab here, right? Go to constructs, if then else, drag it in here, right? So suppose I say my condition here, right? Delete the condition and the angle brackets, put in your real condition. So I could say here, if country name equals quote or single quote Canada, then the continent will be North America, right? Else something else. Okay, so let's test that. No errors, syntactically speaking. Let's drag that after country name. Let's try running it. Okay, so here's Canada. And we don't see our field there. Oh, we forgot to put it in the report. I forgot to put it in the report. And you have to go to the page layout, grab the field, put it on the report. And I'll make it yellow, make it bold, make it bigger so that it stands out. Let's check the country also, right? Okay, now we can run it. Okay, so you see how it works. If the country is Canada, the continent is North America. See, notice also there's a space there. That must be a typo. Oh no, you know what it's doing? It is, I'll bet you I know what it's doing. I'll bet you it's setting it as horizontal alignment, right? Let's make that left. Right. Okay, now it's lined up on the left, right? So you see if it's Canada, it says North America, right? Now that you're not finished yet, because that's not really true, is it? Here's our definition, right? Oh, at the query level, double click on it. Here it is. This is not really true, is it? Right. So let's make some space here, because the truth is, if the country name is Canada, or country name and square bracket is quote United States or bracket country name equals quote Mexico, right? And then if you wanted to be more accurate, you could put in Cuba, all the Caribbean countries, etc. Right? There's an error, parsing error, if country blah blah blah. Right, so let's see what it's complaining about here. If country name equals Canada, United, or United States, country name equals United States. Oh, I've got a square bracket in there. I must have hit the square bracket by mistake. There you are, no errors. Okay. Go to report. Run the report. Look at the report. There it is. There's United States, and there's North America, right? There's India. It's just something else, right? Great Britain is something else, right? You could, the same way as we did before, make nested if statements, right? One if statement inside another if statement, right? Like this. And then you could what we're saying here is if the country is Canada, blah blah blah, North America. If the country name is India, or country name is China, or country name is Philippines, right? Then the continent name is Asia, right? Let's check this. Another syntax error. Pressing error in your position 122. See that the it's not terribly helpful. I see what the error is. It wants an else. Okay, no errors right now. See how small this window is? It's not big enough. There's a problem. IBM, if you're listening, thank you. Right. So what you do is you copy the whole thing. The Control A. Do a Control C for copy. Right. Then you go to Notepad, you paste it into Notepad, right? Then in Notepad, you can make whatever changes you want, right? Like you can do da 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 da, Europe, da da da, Africa, da 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 da. And then when you're all finished, And then you can change the font so that you can see the whole thing, right? And then you can line up everything, right? So that you can actually see whether you made any typing mistakes like this. And then after you're all finished, you can grab the whole thing and then go back and paste it into here, right? Like you could delete this whole thing. I'll do this. Control C, Control X, delete the whole thing. Then go to your notepad, edit, copy the whole thing. Then go back to your empty window here, paste the whole thing in, right? Then test it and say okay. Then run it. Okay, so see here it says Asia for India, right? Bangladesh, I haven't put that in yet. But India is in there, right? I could do that. Right? Query Explorer, continent, double click. Since we don't have any records for China. Bangladesh. We can utilize that area. Okay, there's Bangladesh is in Asia, right? So similarly, you could do any conditions that you want. So that's how you use the if then else, and the same as what I said with the previous video. You can use it in either Framework Manager or Report Studio, but it's better to use it in Framework Manager. Because if you use it in Report Studio, you have it for this report here. I'll call this if then else test. You have it in this report here, but you don't have it in any other report. If you want to put it in any other report, then you would have to write it all over again. And not only that, right? Suppose there's a new country. If you have this defined in 10 reports, then you have to go through 10 reports and make the same change over again, right? Whereas if you have it in one place in the Framework Manager, then you, if there's, when there's a new country, you only have to change it in one place. So that's the lesson, and thanks for watching.